Well, at recess, we had this plan spot behind the tree. We would all talk about it. Roblox this girl even didn't eat her lunch because her teacher took away her fridge.
I don't even watch them again.
We all had this plan to sneak in school and break in, break the windows, go in class and steal all our fridge spinners and give them back to the owners. But every time we talk about it, we'd get caught by this one kid named Nathan. And he would all go tell the teacher. But the teacher didn't care, just obviously, because she knew we weren't going to do it.
So today in English class, our English teacher was going through the rules again, just because I guess like some people were forgetting them or like breaking the rules. So anyway, she was like, just to remind you guys, there's no food in class. No talking to your neighbor without...
What's that? This is the way we done.
You're going to have it taken away and your parents are going to have to come get it. Hello. And when she said that part about the phones, this kid raised his hand and he's like a really creepy kid. And he was like, well, what if I shoot you? Like, hold up. What? You just threatened to shoot a teacher? So I just like looked at him and I scooped my desk away and the whole class went silent. Like nobody said anything. We're all just staring at him. Like we were all just in shock. Like, did he just threaten to shoot a teacher? After like 10 seconds of it being like completely silent, he reached in his backpack.
This is the reason why I treat people the way that I do. And this is how a toxic friend changed my life. Let's set the scene. Fifth grade, I had a best friend, not gonna name her. We were like this. We were partners for everything. Always sat next to each other. If the teacher said, team up, she'd be like, I wanna be a Jozadak. So we would team up. But if we were ever on a team and we were losing, she would blame me. If I got a question wrong, she would call me dumb. If I shared my snacks with her, she wouldn't share any of hers back with me. You guys know those Cosmo brownies with the sprinkles? I would literally force my mom to buy those just for her. And when I'd ask for a chip, she'd be like, never willing to share. We would get into fights a lot. And in turn, I started being mean. But up until that point, I was a pretty wild child. Pretty crazy. Hyper.
What is this? This pretty girl jumped over and she make it to winners, I don't know.
Laughing fast enough in PE, but then the next day would want to be my best friend. I felt like a failure a lot. If I won anything, I'd have to give it to her. And I was mean too. I didn't like the person I was around her. Ooh. Until eventually in art class, I legitimately had an epiphany. She was copying my artwork. I was a pretty good artist. She knew that, so she was copying me.
Story time. So this was 2 years ago and I was at school and it was a normal day until the principal went on the speaker and said, we're in lockdown, go in your closets. So we went ahead and went in the closets. We were all confused. Some people were scared. Everyone was like kind of asking the teacher what was going on.